Everything you need to know about biofuels. Have you heard of biofuels? Biofuels are fuels that are created from organic material, biomass, either directly or indirectly. Organic materials can include those that come from plants or even animal waste. Biofuels are what provide us with bioenergy, which takes care of around 10% of the world's energy needs, and they can be in the form of either a liquid, solid, or a gas. What exactly are the materials that biofuels can be created from? Due to the updates in current technology, biofuels can be extracted from a variety of materials, waste, wood, or crops, for instance. There are both primary and secondary biofuels. The difference is that primary biofuels come from organic materials that is used in its natural form, such as firewood, wood chips, or pellets, but secondary biofuels come from organic material that is processed, such as bio-oil, ethanol, or biodiesel. What are each of these different types used for? The primary biofuels are mostly for cooking, heating, and electricity, while secondary biofuels are often used for motor vehicles and large-scale manufacturing. The secondary biofuels, ethanol and biodiesel, are actually known as liquid biofuels. Ethanol is a type of alcohol that can be produced with the use of any feedstock, raw material used as fuel in manufacturing, that is high in sugar, e.g. sugarcane, or starch, e.g. wheat. Biodiesel is produced through a process called transesterification from either vegetable oils, animal fats, or used cooking oils. Transesterification is a process that converts oils and fats into renewable energy. What else is there to know about biofuels? First-generation biofuels are those that come from biomass that can double as a source of food. Ethanol, for example, is often produced from the fermentation of C6 sugars, such as glucose, using yeast strains that are either GMO or classical. Second-generation biofuels are derived from non-edible biomass, e.g. wheat straw or corn husks, and they are also referred to as advanced biofuels. Their name comes from the fact that they are made up of unique feedstocks that require alternative extraction technologies. Plant matter is made up partly of these second-generation biofuels, and also the organic compound cellulose. Ethanol can be produced from cellulose in a couple of different ways, one being enzymatic hydrolysis. During this process, glucose molecules are broken down into glucose monomers, which are then turned into ethanol. The processes that take place in regards to biofuels help us generate gases to help us carry out things that we do every day. For instance, sometimes solid biomass needs to be converted into gas via a process called gasification. Gasification essentially turns solid organic materials such as wood into gas that we can use. We need this process for important things, such as the generation of electricity and the creation of gasoline and diesel fuel. Other processes that can be used to create second-generation biofuels include pyrolysis, heating an organic material without oxygen, and direct combustion. Biomass is burned in open air or in excess amounts of air. We've heard a lot about all of the great uses of biofuels, but what are the downsides? The use of liquid biofuels also comes with some disadvantages, such as cost, industrial pollution, and global warming. The demand for these biofuels increases each day, and they are extremely expensive to produce in our current market. Not to mention, production increases our carbon footprint and contributes to pollution. Biofuels are meant to be better for the environment. However, the production process for liquid biofuels reverses this due to the fact that large amounts of both water and oil are needed. Adding to that, the burning of liquid biofuels produces carbon dioxide, which is a major contributor to global warming. Despite their positives, liquid biofuels also leave quite a negative impression on our environment with their emissions. As with biofuels, even though something may appear to be environmentally friendly on the outside, it's important to look at it from all angles. This is why it's so important for society to continue exploring other possible solutions for electricity and fuel that don't contribute to global warming and pollution.